Hi, in this episode we are going to remove an item after reaching it, so it looks like we actually picked it up. A reasonable place for that is try getting item function, because we check here if we can get this item. First we will need a public array of game objects called, let's say, objects to remove. Okay, now we can copy that and go to the click manager. There we're gonna create a for each loop for every game object in array items.objects to remove. And inside we will destroy G. We wanna grab everything what is inside this array and get rid of it. Alright, in Unity we want to put our plant there because we want to remove it from the scene as we pick it up. And as we enter play mode and click on this plant, it vanishes, but it happens too soon, so we need to delay it. First, let's organize it a bit and let's create a new function called update scene after action. It will be a private I enumerator because we want to be able to delay some actions. And inside we will wait for player reaching the target. And after that we will simply do the for each loop and send our message. So we don't need it in try getting function anymore. As it comes to waiting, first we need to check if player is walking or not. So let's create a new boolean. In the newly created coroutine, we will constantly check if the player is walking, and if it's true, we wait a while. We'll achieve that by using yield return new wait for seconds. And as an argument, we will use a really small amount of time. And of course, to make it work, we should set player walking to true in go to item. So as we start going to item, we assume that the player is walking. And now we need to think about when we should stop it. When we should set the player walking boolean to false. I think the best place for that would be the end of move to point I enumerator. There we need to check if the object we move is the player from the click manager. So let's find click manager and its player. For now we can't change the player walking boolean from there because it's not a public variable, so let's go to the click manager and set it to public. And now we can set player walking to false. Okay, you probably have an error in the line number 36, and that's because I didn't tell you that we need an item as an argument of this coroutine. Now Unity knows what item we are talking about in this line. And we will also need to wait one frame to make sure that this coroutine won't break. We have to make sure that we wait at least one frame in any coroutine. We also need to use this item here as we call this coroutine. Oh, and I can see that I tried to start this coroutine as a simple function, which won't work. If you wonder, it simply won't start, so let me fix it quickly. Start coroutine is for starting coroutines. Seems to be easy to remember, but sometimes I just don't use it. Oh, and I've written if instead of while, so yeah, you didn't see that. Alright, as you can see, we are moving towards the plant, but it vanishes as we are near it, not as we click it. Alright, and that way we have another element in our game. Good job everyone, and see you in the next video! We are going to create our own sprite animator there, which is, at least for me, a highly interesting topic. I hope that's the same in your case, so have a good day and see you soon!